Here we are with Czechy versus Cash. And the winner, of course, advances to the winner bracket. Semi-final has a way easier way than the loser, of course. And we start on Ancient Isles. But here are your players. First, we have Cash versus Czechy. Both pictures a little outdated. Both players have been to China before. Czechy went to WCA 2014 alongside Sonic, Wojciech Rich, and Hawk, if I'm not mistaken. Cash was at WEC alongside Hawk. That was his biggest accomplishment to date here. And as it seems, Cash still a great track record over Undead's here. 65%, pretty impressive. But against Czechy, it's not looking that good. Only 40%. So on paper, Czechy is a little bit of a favorite. But if we're honest, this we have a favorite here, and that is Cash, since he's way more active. Game number one, here we go. Best of three, obviously. The other maps are Amazonia and... I forgot already. Stupid me, sorry. So, Czechy. He was a micro god back in his day in 2014. Very, very outstanding control. Still a little bit of a whiner, especially against the Mountain King. He won't face a Mountain King here in this match, but he will face a Blade Master. An unpatched Blade Master, of course, where Critical Strike is still pretty crazy. And Claws add to that. Normal build by Cash, who goes for one Burrow Tech, most likely Blade Master with a Barracks, not skipping anything. And on the other side, first Undead today, actually, since 1-2-0 versus Lucifer did not happen. We have a DK, a Fiend build order, but an early DK. So I wonder how he creeps this. Maybe he did some practice with Remo. There are some special Remo creep routes here, as you all are aware. For example, this shop is doable, and then you have level 2. And level 2 helps you a lot, because you need speed to get away from the Blade Master, and level 2 gives you the Unholy Aura, so it's a win-win situation. Blade Master most likely creeping first, then shopping, then harassing. And we have the first two skeletons. This is part of the Remo creep route, but this path isn't. Goes into the middle of the map. There are perchers. There are gnolls. And here we go. So the perch ends up on the DK because he attacked with the DK first. So the perch won't go onto the skeleton warriors. And two coils already invested. This is a very, very fast creep. Making sure that the Blade Master cannot arrive in time. Cash here only sniping the item, which was a Circle of Nobility, very good early game item. And so far, all four skeletons are alive. There we go, Micro is on point at the moment. And yeah, since questions are coming, 3 Western players and 13 Asians, the majority is Chinese. 3 to 5 Koreans, and that is the full list of participants then. For GCS. We have a second circlet bought from the shop. He is expecting Czechy here, but thanks to the special, like a little special creep route, he walks into nowhere, but he's able to get the Ogre Mage. He still has 5 healing selves. Of course, you don't really want to take more than 400 damage. This is a little too much, but can still heal up easily, and with the 2 circlets, you creep this easily. There we go. Ring of Protection for him, dropping super low. Actually, a coil could almost kill him here now. More skeletons for him, and more fiends. Czechy is teching halfway through. How far ahead is Cash? Not too much. So pretty much a fast tech by Czechy as well. Very even game so far. Very... They creep a lot. Very passive game. They leave each other alone to get into a little bit of a groove. And level up their heroes. Of course, we have laboratories here pretty close to the main. This is exploitable by Cash, and we have seen him in NWC3L, where he played against Remo, of all. And he used a lot of zappers here. So Czechy, you should be aware, should be scouting for it, send skeletons along that path, and maybe even a shade, and attach it to the Blade Master's ass. The 2 tech is finishing, and then TC, old school, or Shadowhunter, normal style. These fiends are creeping simultaneously while Czechy is taking out a little bit of this camp here. 4 dust and the Blade Master level 2.5 already. This map is not really designed for a high level Blade Master. not too many claws, not too many boots of Kael Palaces, etc., etc. So letting him creep, I think, is okay. He gets a bit of map control on level 3, obviously, but as long as you have a level 3 DK, I think you're totally fine. And Cechi is coming in for the creep jag. I don't think he's in time, though. The grunts are doing a good job, and the fiends were too late for the final shot. They cancel the heal selves, though. This is very close to 3. And now, just a little bit damage on the Blade Master, but there's plenty of mana and plenty of Windwalk. So, he should be fine. He even has a speed scroll if he wants to engage, but Cechi lets the damage spread on his two fiends and his DK. Focus only on the Blade Master. It's a Shadow Hunter, it's a tier 3 tech, and it's a Beastery. Normal style by Cash. Pretty obvious. Ooh, nice block here. But nothing is about to die, so that's fine. Cechi is delaying tier 3 a little bit, prioritizing the Lich, which is totally understandable, because Frost Armor gives you just so much more control in those fights, if you can protect your units and your first hero and second hero. Claws of Attack already handed over. The Slaughterhouse after the Lich is finishing up now, so statues are coming, and therefore we are finally healing and mana regen. But this is only level 2.3 DK, and I like that Cash is positioning himself closer to Cechi's side, or on Cechi's side of the map. Even if he takes the risk here of being creepjacked, Cechi seems a little afraid of what Cash is doing, but now he kind of returns the favor and walks into Cash's side of the map. This, of course, the one of two chances for the Vamp Aura for Boots of Kael Palaas. And Foggy, a little indecisive. Oh no, he's just pulling out the creeps here. Tanking with the Lich, of course, since you can't heal him a lot. And Hero Armor prevents some damage. This is walled off, so the Blade Master can't do anything. First statue is coming out, as well as more fiends. 50% on the tier 3 tech, and then we have an orb. And then Cechi is ready to fight. Same tech here with a War Mill for the Kodal Beast, of course. 10% damage boost for the entire Orc army, and a second Claws of Attack for the Lich here. So very good inventory. Sometimes it's a little underrated how much of a damage dealer this guy really is. Especially with the Orc. And if he's a little stacked, then things can go out of control. Of course, no crit for him. Would be crazy if there's a crit item. Blade Master got no claw at all. But he's finding the undead finally. A little late, not able to steal this, but he is level 3. Level 2 Windwalk is about to expire, so he sees him. He knows that Cash knows where he is, so he has to take a little bit of risk. But he knows that the army is on the left-hand side of the map, so he can creep this with ease. Everything is a little hurt for Cash, so if there's a fight soon, of course, this is not good for him. But there's plenty of time, and both will gear up on tier 3 before fighting. Cash is not getting the last hit here. He's waiting for the Null. But the DK gets it at level 3 plus level 2 on the Lich. Item is a Pendant of Energy. Cechi with very quick fingers here. And yeah, this is a lot of Frost Armor or Coils now. Destroyer upgrade coming. Tier 3 ready. And the question is, what is Cechi's third hero? You can play Crypt Lord, that is very rare. Same as the Dreadlord. The most common choice would be the Dark Ranger. You can also play a Pit Lord. But if this Blade Master is as under-equipped as he is now, then this is a Dark Ranger play, I guess. On the other side, we have a very tanky Shadow Hunter with the Rune Bracers and the Talisman of Evasion. Both very good for the Blade Master as well. We're going to see a lot of fiends that will attack the Blade Master, so Talisman is an item that you can go for. And again, Cash not getting a single creep just yet. I think he's fine as long as his Shadow Hunter can creep. Oh, reveal being used immediately, coiling and Novaing this Blade Master, getting him down to 50%, and now he wishes that he had the Rune Braces already. Heal wards, pretty decent. Save some mana on the statues. And the TC is there as well. Level 3 on the Shadow Hunter, and level 1 on the TC, who's creeping up more and more and more. And in total, like, there are the best spots are left for Cash. This one, and this one. Cechi is scouting it though with an Acolyte, so he can go for a creep jack if he so desires. Creeps are almost done here, but everything is a little bruised, and he's catching the Shadow Hunter out of position. Same for the TC, who does have the aura now, so it's a little easier to get away. But the Blade Master is not in this fight, so lack of damage at the moment. First Destroyer is out. Chehi so far in a decent position, but here comes the Blade Master already 50%. If there's another Coil Nova, he has to use the Invul Potion. There are Headhunters already going for the Lich immediately. Nice Hacks, and what an execution by Cash, man. Really well done. Hacks at the perfect timing. This was to be expected, but the Lich not there in time. The Dark Ranger not silencing too well, and without the Lich, there's no chance for Chehi at all at the moment. So this is plenty of time now for the Russian Orc to creep further. And of course, big experience as well. But he's moving out again. Is it buying the Lich back from the Tavern? It certainly looks like it. And he's pulling ghouls to have additional damage against the raiders. Here he is, coiling him immediately. This is only 3 coils now. Dark Ranger is at 50% as well. This is a plus 9 Blade Master. With the Kodo, this is going to be a little more. Does he have the aura? Yes, upgraded aura as well for even more damage. Shop control now for Chehi. He also has a mana potion for even more coils, so that's good. But the Fiends are up front. There's not a real blocker line. Dispel immediately, silence, nice against the TC, there's a heal wave, that is okay. No rune braces on the Blade Master, that could hurt him. He's focusing him hard, and now triggers the Invul Potion. The heal ward is doing a great job, in addition to the statues. That of course stacks, but the statue is taken out by the Blade Master, who has to be careful, knows that he has to get back into the fight. Does he have, yeah, he has a heal scroll now. Reveal being used, coil hits him. Is there a Nova to follow it up? Nope, there's not. And now the DK is in trouble, standing right next to the ward, but that's about it. Can he nuke the Blade Master? Otherwise this DK is dead, or has to TP out. Invul Potion it is. Long range coil, but it's not enough. 11 HP, and Cash saves his first hero there. Good block against this grunt, and damage coming in. Whoa, this is an excellent block. The Dota skills coming out for Chehi. And that was quite a comeback here. With a heavy, heavy nuke on the Blade Master, and now it goes the same for Cash. Like with that, with a hurt Blade Master, he cannot fight. And he's giving. Oh, he's selling the. No, did he swap it or sell it? Okay, he sold the Talisman of Evasion, but now the Rune Braces are on the Blade Master to prevent this magic damage. Ankh of Reincarnation. We saw massive hero focus on both sides, so the Ankh might be okay. How much mana is there on the Lich? Nothing! So he needs Dark Ritual, but he doesn't have it, as he has level 2 Nova most likely. Silence again, here's the Hex again. This time he moves out the Lich in time and coils him. The TC is falling, but there's an aura behind it. Nice, dropping the pendant right next to the Blade Master before using the Mana Potion. Nice synergy here, but the Dark Ranger is down once again. And Chehi seems like he's losing the fight. 43 supply only, he's trying to get this hero kill, and he successfully does it. So he gets the revenge kill on the third hero with a level 2, so his aura is gone now. And everything for the undead is a little faster, but that is the last remaining fiend. Only the destroyer there, but he gets an end snare and will fall in a bit as well. So it's heroes and statue only against a pretty significant orc army, I would say. 46 supply. Cash is not losing too much. And yeah, he's getting close to level 4, but that's not a big upgrade. Level 4 on the Shadow Hunter now as well, man. This is sick. And Cash aiming for the Lich one more time. He does have backstep in a bit. Hex on the Lich, actually. But yeah, that's about it. DK falls, level 4. And the Lich will fall as well. Chehi calls for the GG. And this is first game over here. Cash, the favorite, prevailing in on map number 1. After 13 minutes. So that was pretty one-sided. Of course, it all started to go downhill with a Lich kill, which was so fast. It was quite sick. We have a few new subs here today. Hotfix Guru has gifted a sub to Account Create. Thank you very much for that. And Ixwap for 14 months already. Hey there, he says. Hey there, and thank you for your contribution. So, second map is coming. And it is Amazonia. So between the matches, I have to ticker a little for read more. Do you guys know the score of Foggy versus Scut? I imagine the games go a little longer, since Scut is usually playing Gargoyles, and Gargoyle games last longer. Ah, nice! Yehu is there! Awesome! Okay, so I don't have to chicker. That's fantastic. Thank you, Yehu, backbone of the German community for quite some time. Thank you, Mr. Winner, for the host. Checky isn't so great memes, yes, obviously. It's cool that he still has this love for Warcraft, and I can only imagine that after the patch hits, then he will play a lot more again. But yeah, it was quite a close situation. If he kills the Blade Master there with a 10 HP. If he kills the Blade Master there with 10 HP, then the game could definitely go in his favor. But if he didn't, and Cash came back, and even the math pressure couldn't withstand it in the end. So, who's gonna be the first one making it into the winner bracket semi-final? If Cash wins this map, he's through, and we'll meet the winner of Sonic and Effect, will play on this very channel right after this game. So, how will he play this time? Looks like a standard build again, with the altar, no shop, or like no early shop, with the barracks there. On Czechy's side, we see an Altar of Darkness, so it's again a fast DK going into Fiends later. Czechy, the only player from the Czech Republic here. We had Giacomo and Bonecracker back in the day, so quite a history of undead players from the Czech Republic. Of course, the loser will still be alive. You need to lose two matches to be eliminated, but making it through the entire lower bracket is really, really hard. As you have to win like 5 games in a row. Plus the grand final. Here's the shop that we were expecting, so he's not rushing tier 2. He will have quite a bit of attack advantage since Czechy is going for Fiends, which is of course a tier 1.5 unit. You need the graveyard for it, and since you need the graveyard for it, the attack will be delayed, but you all know this, I guess. Do you think Cash could be a threat to Foggy? I mean, the games between Cash and Orkworker are always 50-50, or most of the time. So I wouldn't be surprised to have Cash over Orkworker in this tournament. But over Foggy. Foggy is the guy to beat. That is for certain. He's the Apollo of European Warcraft. Vice World Champion. Whenever he can prepare for his opponent, he is really, really, really strong. So not that great in cups. Basically like me. On a smaller scale, of course. Having a lot of the history that Moon has, but who does? Tier 2 tech on the way, second Burrow right after. Sold the ring immediately. And Czechy creeping up. Not going for the laboratory, but to this little troll camp. And this is scouted by Cash immediately. He has to use a coil, otherwise, yep, there's the backstab, there's additional experience for the Blade Master, and he gets closer to level 2. At least he got the item here. The Gauntlets of Ogre Strength are plus 3 damage and a little bit of HP for him. Czechy is teching now as well. Quite fast for an undead. So no fiend out yet. 17 supply tech. Taking quite a risk here, as the Blade Master can just dominate him. And Cash abuses this, well, abuses, capitalizes from this by killing the Renegade Wizard. It's basically the same tactic we saw on Ancient Isles already, where he crept a lot of Czechy's side of the map. There was a little bit of a revenge later on when he got the laboratory, but it's fine. Second Circlet for the Russian as well. Who was, of course, also playing European Nations Cup for his team back then. And still a level 1 DK. Can cancel the heal self here, which is quite nice. Oh, nice. Uses Windwalk before, is dusted, but out of range for a coil. So the heal self goes on, saves him 30 gold, 33 gold.
A player's forces are under attack.
Very early merchant. He acquires the Berserker and goes for the Renegade. Of course, he won't creep the entire camp. That would be too much damage. But the big item, it's a belt of giant strength with seeing how low he is at the moment. Not the worst addition, and we saw a lot of hero focus in these games, or in game one before. So maybe having a little bit of an extra HP is not too bad. DK finally gets up to level 2. That took some time. 4 minutes 30 is not ideal, as the Blade Master here is getting to level 2.3. Usually level 3 is not that much of a problem. Checky's doing a good job so far. Oh, score is wrong, sorry. Cash, of course, with the 1-0 lead. Fixed now. It's only 2 fiends. He's at 23 supplies. This must be such a fast tech. Ah, it is quite a fast tech. It is finished now. So time for the Lich. But here's the first engagement. Cash not willing to commit to this too much. Doesn't want to get bashed or anything. But the Blade Master, of course, luring around. Will be in the shadows. There we go. Does he have dust? Yes, one more dust is there. And he needs to use it! Cash got it. The item went to Chechy, which are watch awards. But he needs that experience. He's almost out-leveled by an entire level. And that gives him level 3. Level. Shadowhunter out. Bestiary.
A player's forces are under attack.
So the normal build again. Tier 3 tech on the way. Not for Chechy though. Once again, Lich before Slaughterhouse, before tier 3. And here we have it again. Hex. This is actually Cash being a little more aggressive on this smaller map. Moving out into the middle with the Shadowhunter isn't that normal. Ooh, that Berserker though. It's a little faster. Can't run away. Would be nice if this skeleton could just throw his sword. Yeah, if he doesn't miss micro, this Berserker is alive. Ah, uses the heal stuff, that's okay. Chechy has no safe spots to creep except for his Murlocs. Even the shop could be contested with a level 3 blade. Because he's just moving all over the map.
A player's forces are under attack.
Now it's creeping time for both second heroes. This time the Wormel is a little more early. Tier 3 lines up with it perfectly. We have a Bestiary with, of course, Raiders. That's no surprise, so no special strategies for Cash. Also, no usage of the laboratory yet. Neither for, I don't know, Zeppelins nor Zappers. Didn't really need it. And level 2 for the Shadowhunter, there he is. Heal wave activated. On the other side we have, of course, Frost Armor. Level 2 DK still, this is such a pain for Chechy. But now with the Skeleton, he sees where the Orc army is. And the Skeleton usage so far by Chechy is really good.
A player's forces are
like, he has constant vision. This is a little bit of a multitasking thing. And if you tend to be lazy, you kind of forget about it. But it's so important. Even though if you give a little bit of XP to your opponent, but the vision and info, so worth it. Mass boulder toss. Doesn't really hit the Lich, but whatever. So this is natural. Big consumable here. Even the Scroll of the Bees could be huge, as there is no dispel. So level 2, Shadowhunter, level 1, Torrent Chieftain, coming level 3 on the Blade Master. This all lines up well. Chechy is in trouble. It is the big mana potion. The best item here. The Blade Master stole a lot throughout this game. The big Taskmaster would have given them level 3 here. Almost, at least. And the Shadowhunter level 2.5. Reinforced defenses. Standard upgrade. As well as the Kodos with the Aura soon. Also, Chechy finally on tier 3. We have Destroyer Form. Burrow coming. With Burrow you can do a lot of fancy tricks. And saves. That so far didn't work too well for him. At least not on AI. Maybe he needs to warm up a little. Level 3 on the Shadowhunter. Plus Kodo Beasts is out. So, I think Chechy has no invul yet. There is an invul on the Blade Master if he steals this one. Where are the reveals? He gets the rune bracers again. The inventory, the experience goes towards Czechy this time. But rune bracers are so nice. At least he gets level 3 and 2 from this. At least he gets Coil Nova. But he's also getting Creepjack. Here comes the reveal. Coil Nova, but rune braces. You see them work. And the heal wave right after the TC comes in. This is going to be an at percentile. Actually, doesn't hit too well. The statue is gone, though. Has to micro the second one. And can he get a revenge kill here? TC, maybe there's no Dark Ranger yet. He has no silence at all. Great timing by Cash to go for this Creepjack. As the Kodo doesn't have the upgrade yet, but it's there. And now he stuns almost everything that was in this army. The Kodo is super low, but it's hero focus all over the place. The Coil Nova again. And that scares the Blade Master away. He used his Invul already. Is there another heal wave? Not really. Munchy Munchy, the Kodo is hungry, or was at least. Czechy with a Mud Golem. Muddy the Mud Golem, and he executes the TC with it. Great comeback by Czechy, staying alive here. And with another Coil, he can certainly get that Berserker. Okay, there is the saving heal wave, but the Lich is too strong. And this slow, man, this Mud Golem is paying off so hard. Lich in trouble, getting focused. He has a Coil already, and there was the big mana potion. He's full mana again, but the Hex is in time. There's Purge to get rid of this Frost Armor. It could be in time. Where's the DK? There we go. Coil hits him. 10 HP before dying, and this is time to evacuate. Can get a slow out, but no dispel with the Destroyer, but that was a great, great fight for Czechy. Backed against the corner, coming back, swinging, and with mercenary support, even Muddy the Mud Golem, MVP of this comeback. And now, for the first time, we have the undead with the upper hand. And Cash just licking his wounds. Going for Berserkers now. And now the Dark Ranger. He's supply stuck. He has to kill one Acolyte or something. Maybe Muddy has to suffer for this? I mean, or is he waiting for Ziggurat to finish? A player's forces like it. Are under attack. No shade yet, by the way. No pit. TC level 1. Oh, is he looking for Zappers? Yes, he is. Czechy, will you scout this? No. Will you react accordingly to it? We will see. The Acolyte is there. More Acolytes are there. There is damage. Can he explode? He will explode. Nice micro so far. He gets rid of one Ziggurat. But that's about it. He can't cancel it again, though. And I think he didn't deny it. Oh, the Blade Master. On that spot. Very, very annoying. But here comes the rest of the army, and he has no Invul. He has no potion. All he has is Windwalk using the Coil. Where is the Nova? He needs to slow him down. Can he reach? Does he have mana? Yes, he does. Didn't commit to this. So, this is a great way for Orcs to come back. Kill a Ziggurat to prevent the undead from breaking upkeep. Oh, 200 plus 2. That's why you picked them up, Czechy. Plus 2 damage on this blade. Almost the slippers. And this is too risky for Cash now to creep as the undead is moving to the upper left. He did not know about the creeping, I guess. In the upper left, as the Belt of Giant Strength was already gone. And sold. Czechy's pulling the creeps, but I think, yeah, he doesn't want to creep this. He knows that the Orc is right around the corner. This is either an Invul or a Heal Scroll. I think it's an Invul. So much hero focus here in these games, right? It's crazy. And it is an Invul. We have a Heal Potion here, but nothing on the Shadowhunter. Also, no Mana Potion. In Czechy's base, there's nothing happening. Staying at 50. Oh no, 56 actually. Cash staying at 50. New character running. The next fight must be better for Cash. And it will be, since it is a creep check. Blade Master's coming in, been revealed already. I think he can get him with a backstab and one hit. But the item goes towards Czechy, and it's a freaking greater mana potion again. This is 600 mana that he found, the Blade Master. Oh man, was he slot starved? Not really, right? And with four additional coils, you can certainly take the next fight. How's the mana situation on the Lich? Great. Where's the Silence of the Dark Ranger hitting both of the units, immediately sniping the Kodo? And that's the only one he can't devour, he doesn't have the aura anymore. It's gone now, first destroyer right next to the Troll Berserkers, which is not what you want. But, okay, 5 supply gone, reinforcements are coming in, more and more range attack here. But he's nuking the Blade Master, Invo Potion triggered already. The Groot Bracers are quite good, Invo Potion on the DK is super important. And now, he's getting rid of the rest of the army. Level 4 DK, here we go. Can go for Death Pack to be safe. Or Aura level 2. We don't see it yet. Might be Death Pack. Long range coil. But there's more damage. But there's also an Invo Potion. I love how Chechi is taking care of his inventory. But there's still decent damage in this army. Kodo is back. Nice, but a little too late. He can't really nuke the TC because he still has a potion. He would love to get this Kodo. Didn't eat anything. He wanted to coil something. Maybe Kodo, but whatever. Once he reaches 4 and 2 on Lich and Dark Ranger, it's icy times. Oh, nice. Second destroyer down. Cash is coming back into this game. He's doing it so well. He doesn't have a raider anymore, so Chechi can just walk away as his aura. Oh, it's not actually better. It's 10% for both. Oh, DK almost surrounded there, tanking a lot of damage from two heroes and a grunt. These reinforcements, man, walking right into the Orc army. This is not how it's supposed to be. He can't get rid of the Kodo anymore. He's just lacking damage. And it looked so great. But in the end, this Blade Master on level 4 with critical strike level 2 came the swing. Oof, close to eating a fiend. And he finally got rid of it. Blade Master damage significantly lowered. But what does it matter if you crit? 150 on level 2. I think only a hero focus can save Chechi, but there's no mana on the Lich anymore! No Dark Ritual! But Death Pack, waiting for level 4. Did so many Headhunters, I think it could be time for an Abomination, which is coming. To soak up more damage, he needs a blocker line. His fiends are dying so fast to this. It's almost tragic. Another gauntlets. The Blade Master is sniffing him out again. This is another big investment by Chechi into items. 250 gold. Could have been a feat. But he needs those invo potions. Especially once the TC reaches level 3. And the stun duration is prolonged. Need to be safe for that. Abomination is not there. Statues are there. Fiends are there and the heroes. Does he really want to fight with this? 50 supply versus 43 only. The Orc army looks significantly bigger. If he's able to reach level 4 on the Lich, and if he's able to go for Death Pact, then, or Dark Ritual, whatever it is. Then I see a lot of nukes and I see Orc heroes falling. Well, that's quite a long path as the map is almost empty. Only the red spots remaining, but the skeleton sees Cash coming. Oh, he attacks him before. He engages this spot though. It's daytime. He might be able to see him. Most likely not. But he can engage. Quite easily, I'd say. The A-bomb is there though. Pretty open battlefield. And off we go. We have a nuke on the Blade Master again. The Rune Braces are still on him and an Invo Potion. But he forces him away and that's level 3. I think there was still a level 1 stun. It was good though. Yeah, without Destroyers, he is lacking damage. He kills the Grunt. Okay, Blade Master is almost back to full health. Nice little stun. The Dark Ranger is surrounded. He can coil him as long as he wants. He wanted to get some time for the Blade Master nuke. Oh, actually the Dark Ranger survives. Doesn't want to stay in there. The shots of Lich and Fiends against Headhunters are quite significant. And again, attack. No Destroyer to do this. Expansion coming up though. Chechi scouts it once again immediately. We don't see a Banshee house. We don't see a Worm pit. So no transition from Chechi, who was casting with Remo last Saturday when there was the open qualifier for GCS. Blade Master is coming in. He got it. He got it. And the item as well. Hood of Cunning and level 4.5. Perfect timing for Cash. And more damage. He's at plus 23. Plus more mana. 460 mana. This thing has so many backstabs. And he's long distance mining already to get a little bit of additional gold. Never wrong when the game revolves around items. You can finance that with long distance mining if it's not getting caught. Invul on the DK, invul on the Lich. That's about it. Heal potion on the Blade, heal potion on the Shadowhunter. Oh, actually, that was the one. And on the TC. Tiny Great Hall. There is nothing on the Blade Master. Can he steal something here? With the faster fingers, looks like it's Chechi. And he got that invul potion. So, this dude is naked. And this is where the Orc army revolves around. Level 4.5. Once he gets to level 3, his crits are on. And I think then you need damage mitigation in forms of... you need Banshees. Once he's level 5, you need Banshees, obviously. No Lodge. Just more Raiders and Walkers. But the timer is on Chechi. I don't think he can afford this Banshee house at the moment. Is he breaking upkeep? Yes, 57. He gets the second one finally. Legion Doom one, of course, an item for the shop. Trades it against the Heal Scroll, maybe. Is he to 4? I think he should creep the Lich solo to get death back. Dark Ritual. Wait, is he really waiting for another invul? A player's I mean, it's a small map. It's okay. Another Kodo. How many does he have? 2 then. It's fine. 2 towers as well. And Cash is mining here. No counter expansion. And it's barely not enough for level 5. 4. That might be a counter expansion. Sends out 2 acolytes. Why is he sending out 2 acolytes? In case one of them forgets the task or something? I don't know. The map is empty. Maybe a little rock golems here and there. But finally, Cash is able to get his invul potion. Will Chechi get this expansion up? That's the biggest question here. No mining anymore for Cash. His gold mine collapsed, but. Here at the expansion, he has it. And this is risky because there's a laboratory, you can bomb stuff, and it's so hard to get the expansion up in general. But he's trying! And that is the big investment that prevents the Banshees. For now, at least. So, inventory for Cash. Is the invul potion, heal potion, and heal potion. I guess mana potion as well, he's just waiting for the gold. As he is in upkeep. Chechi as well, 61 supply. So, what are the mana potion? Yes. Well equipped inventory for Cash. Will he make it into the semi-final with a 2-0? Good advance. Oh, good shot here to intercept this abomination. The second one, actually. Very, very tanky with the frost armor, but here we go. Is it Chechi in the lower bracket, or can he force a game 3? He's nuking the Kodo Beast immediately, but there is a second one somewhere. Yeah, right next to him. Didn't eat yet, doesn't want to commit, but the fight is starting good. Kodo down and one grunt. Sacrifices it for another Fiend Scroll. Protection even being used. There's no dispel, so why not? Frost Armor plus Protection Scroll is certainly nice, but again, the Undead is backed against the corner, trying to nuke the Blade Master, but there is an Invul Potion. The Destroyer is getting nuked by these Headhunters, and it dies. The focusing here, not perfect. This Raider could have died long time ago, and everything for Chechi is a little bit all over the place. He gets the second abomination back, which is huge, especially now that he's trying to eat up the Berserkers. First one down, he needs 2 volleys for them. Dark Ranger again in problems. How's the mana on the Death Knight? 2 more, plus an invul potion that he can swap if it's a hero, and Cash has to get away. Even swapping the potion over to the Blade Master, but this expansion is coming through, and I did certainly not expect this, but it is a level 4 Lich. It's a lot of Nova with all the skeletons. Dark Ranger, of course, Black Arrow, level 2. Oh, it's actually level 1, right? Yeah, it's Silent level 2. Nice stun there, but not hitting the DK. He can coil, still 2 more. Doesn't want to invest it into the Fiends. Oh, the TC is almost surrounded there. What a mistake by Chechi to let that go. But the Dota skills again, but there's the Shadow Hunter right next to him with a mana potion that he used before. Invul on all 3 undead heroes. The Dota player is giving Cash a tough, tough, tough life. He's mining again. 47 supply versus 52. It's not too many headhunters anymore, so destroyers could be a thing soon. With only one stat, you of course you don't want that. And Cash is checking the reinforcements, or checking the reinforcements with that position. Nice coil. Late Masterman has no mana, no Windwalk. Is there a Nova? There is a Nova. He could use it into the Blade Master, maybe prevent level 5, but he's full HP with the Rune Bracers, so that's okay. Gets one Kodo back, but that's level 5. See, the crits explode. It's time for 200 plus critical strikes, and that's the last statue. Without a statue, usually undeads can't fight. Only an abomination there to do damage, but I guess that's the task for the Kodo. And if one hero falls, then this game should be over. The synergy is too well, everything relies on one on each other. Doesn't even need to snack, the damage is enough. I like how Cash is ignoring the heroes just to have a little bit of fun, and as I say it, he kills the DK, and that is certainly the GG. Here we go, Czechy in the lower bracket, Cash clean sheet and winner bracket semi-final for him, where he will meet Sonic or Effect. That is our second game here today. And we will show it, hopefully, right after, as 1,700 people are watching. Thank you very much. And that expansion, man, I don't know about it. So hard to get it up. Maybe it was the bad decision. I don't know. Maybe try to get into Banshees earlier. And then go for an all-in push. I think that's doable. The Blade Master at the end was just crazy. And if you have no damage mitigation, then fairly normal to lose those games in the end. Thank you, Navas, for the Prime sub. So, do we have a result of Foggy versus Scud? Foggy had the 1-0 lead. And Foggy wins 2-0. So, both favorites prevail here in the first round. As you can see here. Foggy and Cash making it, waiting for their opponents now. That will be our next match, is Orkworker versus Hawk and Sonic versus Effect. If you want to go for Hawk or Worker, then feel free to join Hi2Chaco's stream or have them both on at the same time and switch between games as we are doing Sonic versus Effect. Tiny little break here, and then next game in this GCS Summer Europe Qualifier number 1.